We actually think that linguistics is a science just like natural sciences. And the reason is that, in fact, when we talk to each other, we talk in a very natural way and we understand each other very clearly and very quickly. And most of the sentences are directly interpreted with a unique interpretation and unambiguously. And this is something that is a property of the human brain. Just like the visual system is a property of the human brain, and that's why if we want to study how humans read and how humans look and analyze the visual scene around them, we study the human brain. Likewise, when we want to understand how people understand language quickly and can produce sentences at ease, and you can understand me even though the sentences you hear are not necessarily sentences that you heard in the past, you want to go to the brain and study that. The framework within which I'm operating, in fact, takes knowledge from several disciplines. The first discipline is the discipline of linguistics. And what linguistics give you is a framework to study the structure of knowledge that every human being has, by virtue of which they actually can use, understand, and speak whatever language it is that they happen to be speaking. And importantly, this is a kind of knowledge that to some extent is independent of the specific language that you speak. You're just a human being and you happen to be a speaker of Italian. I happen to be a speaker of Hebrew, English. And this is just an accident of birth, of your having been lucky to be born in Venice, okay? And me being less lucky, okay? It's just an accident. What's more important is that both of us are human and we have the same kind of brain. For all we know, we have the same kind of brain. So you want to study language in a general manner that would be true. You want to discover the truth about the nature of language in a way that's independent of a specific language. This is what you want to do. My perspective takes the knowledge from linguistics, as I just said, which studies the structure of language, and then takes a brain perspective. And what you do is you study, in my case, two kinds of phenomena. First of all, you want to study those parts of the brain which are in charge of language processing. Just like when you study vision, you look at those parts of the brain that are in charge of visual processing. I do it in two different ways. First of all, I look at healthy adults. And the way to do it nowadays is using fancy technologies like MRI, magnetic resonance imaging. And we look at what happens in the blood vessels of your brain when you talk and understand language. And from that, we infer something about the underlying neural activity. This is one thing. A second thing that we study is the linguistic ability of people with language impairment, people who have problems. In my case, I study people who have undergone stroke, some kind of an event, usually of a vascular nature, to the brain, and which unfortunately led to a loss of a piece of the tissue. And the idea is to localize particular language mechanisms in particular parts of the brain with the hope of then understanding the mechanisms of each of these brain pieces. So if there's one slogan that needs to be maintained, it's the slogan that says, pieces of knowledge in pieces of brain. This is what's known in psychology and in linguistics as the modularity hypothesis, one that says, it's not as if everything is equally represented in every part of the brain, rather there are specializations of particular sides and particular aspects of your brain, and these specializations embed within them pieces of knowledge. In our case, we look for very tiny, precisely characterized pieces of linguistic knowledge.